the Phoenix Suns have evolved and it's scary. Even without Devin Booker for the last 7 outings, fans in the Valley have seen their team go 5-2 over that stretch, maintaining the number one record in the NBA. DeAndre Ayton trimmed down 10 pounds during his time in health and safety protocol, looking mobile and beastly in his return. Young phenoms on the wing in Mikal Bridges and Cameron Johnson have stepped up tremendously in the absence of D-Book, and the identity established by Coach Monty Williams from their breakout 2021 campaign has carried over to 2021-22. So stay tuned to find out the main reason for why the Suns are so overwhelming for their opponents. Quickly, only 12.2% of you watching right now are subscribed, so if you haven't already, please subscribe. Also leave a thumbs up, it takes a few seconds and makes a massive difference. Also, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at DFlowHoops, links in the description for those two platforms. The Phoenix Suns have become a powerhouse. Following a win versus the Washington Wizards on Thursday night, the reigning Western Conference champions' current home winning streak prolonged to 13 straight games. Locking down the scuffling Wizards by holding them to just 98 points, the team from the Valley is now a perfect 10-0 when the opposing team posts less than 100 points. More notably, Phoenix is now 20-0 when keeping opponents under 110 points. They have the best road winning percentage in the NBA at 77%, which chalks up to a 10-3 record. The Suns have the best record in the clutch, they're 12-1. They've got the most wins against plus 500 teams at 12, and the best winning percentage against plus 500 teams as well. The massive 20-point blowout over the nation's capital moved the Suns to 18-0 on the year when leading entering the fourth quarter. Two of their top four players in Book and Ayton have missed a significant period of time. The Suns went 7-1 in the 8 games Ayton missed. They've so far gone 5-2 in the 7 games Devin Booker's missed. When at full strength, Devin's numbers are a bit down. It's nothing to be concerned about, but his 23.2 points per game, that's the lowest mark since the 2016-17 season. His 45.8% field goal percentage is the lowest since 2017 to 2019. That just goes to show you that this is the best roster surrounding Booker in his career by far, even topping last season's conference championship roster. The Suns have one less L than Golden State, and yet not one player is having a standout breakout year statistically. While on paper no one's had a breakout year per se, Cam Johnson and Mikal Bridges have quietly improved certain aspects of their game. Johnson and Bridges are now known as the Twins, a nickname coined by DeAndre Ayton because they're always around each other and play a similar position and style. In the last 10 games, most of which have been without the face of the franchise and two-time All-Star, without Book, Cam Johnson's stepped up. Cam's posting 13 points, 5 rebounds, and a steal per game on shooting splits of 46% from the field, a blistering 45% from deep range, and 85% from the foul line. Impressive efficiency for the third-year player. Meanwhile, the fourth-year player, Mikal Bridges, has been known as an elite 3-and-D guy for quite some time now, but as you can see from this clip, the man's developing some shot creation off the dribble. From 3 to 10 feet, so around the key, Bridges is making a career-best 53.2% of those shots. Evidently from that stat, Mikal's in-between game has really improved in year 4 of his career. Bridges recently hit his first unassisted 3 of the season, as you can see right here. Keep an eye on that aspect of his development. Given he's 25 years old, I don't think it's fair to say that Mikal is what he is at this point. Personally, I think Phoenix's wing still has a ton of untapped potential. The next step in his development is creation off the dribble, and it's crucial Mikal continues to experiment with those attempts because both Bridges and his good friend up front DeAndre Ayton becoming all-star caliber players would potentially unlock a dynasty for the talented Suns. The man in the middle, DeAndre Ayton, is looking lean and mean following his weight loss, and the maturity that I've seen from Ayton over the last year or two has been great to see. Considering he was suspended for an illegal substance in his rookie year, Ayton's come a very long way since then, and everyone seems to forget about that suspension because of how well he's played. In his return from protocol, Ayton dropped 28-13 against Portland, and he followed that up with a 15-10 game on Thursday night. So as you can see, the young talent for Phoenix of course goes very deep. Having said that, the success all begins with the point guard. Chris Paul has been instrumental in the success of the Suns and continues, even at his advanced age, to set the standard for excellence. He's leading the league in assists with 10.1, despite not being the most athletic player on the court. Also, in his second go-around with Phoenix's young core, CP3's chemistry with his fellow top Suns players has definitely evolved. Paul's probably been shocked by how functional the Suns organization has been during his tenure in Phoenix. The newest pickup, Landry Shamet, spoke about the flurry of talent on the roster, saying, "We're deep for sure. I think more than anything is we play together, we trust each other, play the right way, in a way that enables us to have those numbers and multiple guys in double figures. Every night, it could be somebody different in the spot. We have a lot of interchangeable pieces, guys who are comfortable in filling in different roles." 8 Suns players scored in double figures against the Wizards on Thursday, including all 5 starters, as Phoenix moved to 15-1 on the year when 6 or more players score 10-plus points each. And Thursday also marked the first time at least 8 Suns players scored in double figures since May 16, 2021 in San Antonio. Coach Monty said postgame, "The ability to have that many guys score, especially on a night like this when the energy, it wasn't bad at all, but we knew we were going to be hurting in this game. I think the guys are still sore from that Portland game because it was long and physical. It's just cool to see that many guys score the ball like that, and to get that kind of production from your bench is an indicator of the depth we have." Considering the depth of this team, coupled with the team's performance relative to putting the Wizards away, the starters received some much-needed rest on Thursday. It's one thing to get players game day rest on the front end of a back-to-back, you know they'll have to play the next night, but with an off day, rest on a game day, and then 2 days off afterwards, the rest comes at a key time for Phoenix. Monty Williams said, quote, "To rest our guys in that situation, the starters anyway, is a bonus to us after Chris Paul playing 40 plus the other night. The energy exerted in that game against Portland, I didn't know what to expect tonight. First game back from a back-to-back on the road, but I was just proud of how our team responded to the week that we've had." The culture in Phoenix has changed drastically over the past few seasons. Gone are the days of, "I don't want to be here." There's a buy-in to what their vision is, and a camaraderie unlike anything we've seen in the franchise's past. They go to Mercury games together, they miss each other on off days, they're a team in every aspect of the word. With the win, the Suns move to 23-5 on the season, the team's best start to a season through the first 28 games since opening the 04-05 season 24-4. It's tied as the second best record in franchise history through the first 28, matching the 1992-93 and 80-81 Suns' 23-5 start. They're doing it not only by lighting up the advanced metrics or on the back of a superstar, they're doing it in a team manner, led by a point guard and fueled by a pristine execution of their game plan from the top to the bottom of their roster. They're designed for sustainable success. So, what's the most dangerous aspect of the Phoenix Suns in your opinion? Best answer in the comments gets next video's shoutout. The top 3 commenters with the most shoutouts by the 25th of December are going to receive NBA merchandise in the holiday season, so leave your take on today's question to compete in Community Speaks. Today's Speaks winner is Mark Davis, who says, "What makes this Cavs team special is their boat racing teams without a single player averaging even 20 a game." Pause to read the rest of Mark's amazing take. Thanks for sticking around and leaving your answer in the comments. Hope you have a great one. This was D-Flow, and I'll see you next video.